John, are you there?
I'm here, and the doctor is now a giant robot. How the hell am I supposed to bring him back alive?
Mr. Slade, did you say Dr. Simon has undergone some sort of cybernetic enhancement? If you cannot return Dr. Simon to us in his original form, I must insist you retrieve his brain. We cannot pay you otherwise. We need his brain, Mr. Slade.
How the hell am I supposed to do that?
You are the Shadowgun. You figure it out.
Get me the elevator, Sarah.
I have overridden the elevator controls. It will take some time to arrive. John, this should be operational by now.
I have an idea. If I can reroute my suit's cooling system, I can flash free Simon's brain or something like that. What do you think?
It could work.
Good. Also, I need you to access Federation records for a list of Toltec employees deceased within the past year.
Is something wrong?
Just get me that list.
Worship me! Fear my power! My might!
Gotcha! Time to eat dust! You can't hide from me! You can run, but you can't hide!
Can't get enough of Doc's surprises.
John, I have found the data requested. Toltec reports 32 deceased scientists in their genetic research division. Causes of death, unspecified. Location of death, planet Eve.
Dr. Simon couldn't force 32 scientists to go with him. They were all on Eve from the start, ever since Simon started working for Toltec.
That seems highly probable.
Toltec put Dr. Simon on this planet. They gave him a research team, they assisted in kidnapping the locals, they poured money into his whole enterprise. Toltec wanted Dr. Simon to create an army of mutants, better than human, cheaper than androids.
Dr. Simon rebelled, however.
Exactly. He wanted it all for himself, so he killed his entire research team. He thinks he's a god.